My job is basically what you see Jonah Hill and Miles Teller do in the movie War Dogs.
Question that still has no clear answer. How did two 20-something young men land a $300 million Pentagon contract?
Let's get honest. I took a poll over on my Instagram at Stay Ahnest, and if you're not following, please do, I'd really appreciate it. And I asked, would you guys rather see a review of the glorious GMMK Pro, or would you rather want to know what I do for my day job? And 75% of you voted you wanted to hear what I do for work. So that's what this is. I am what they call a capture manager. And if you're wondering, what the hell is that? What kind of doctor, lawyer, or engineer is that? You're racist, because not all Asians are those things. Although there are a lot of Asians that are those things. So is that still racist? Anyways, I'm totally just kidding. So the best pop media slash maybe even only more movie portrayal of what I do is in the movie War Dogs. And unlike War Dogs though, I don't deal in ammunition or guns or tactical gear or anything like that, but the concept is very, very similar. So in that movie, Jonah Hill is essentially looking for what the government needs. Oftentimes the government wants to buy services or products. The government is the number one purchaser in the world, and essentially they put out these things called government contracts. And in the contract it states, this is what we want, this is when we need it by, and this is why we need it. And it'll go out to the public. And if you guys wanna see some of these contracts, go on a website called sam.gov. You can see all kinds of stuff that the government wants to buy.
Bro, they buy everything on here.
And my company, or a group of companies, because you can team together, will put in a proposal or a bid stating, this is what we'll do, this is how we'll do it, and this is why we're better than the other guys, and this is how much it's gonna cost you. And this is where I come in. My job is to create the winningest team with the winningest proposal at the winningest price.
Not to mention your bid was far too attractive for us to pass up.
But what did you mean by that exactly?
He means you boys lowballed the shit out of your competition.
You guys came in $53 million lower than the nearest competition.
So I have to get all of those things right, because the government will take all the proposals that come in from the various teams and companies, they'll evaluate and they'll pick the best one, and then they will award it to you. And of course, once you're awarded the contract, you will either provide the goods and or products that you promised, or you'll provide the services. And if it's service, then you're gonna hire people that go and work on that contract. And those guys are called government contractors. So if you yourself, or you know somebody who is a government contractor, I'm essentially your counterpart. I'm the person who won that contract that you're serving on. Like I said before, this is exactly what you see Jonah Hill and Miles Teller do, except they are bidding on government contracts specifically for weapons.
The government had a public website containing every military contract currently up for bidding.
But I skip the big ticket items and look for the small bullshit that giant defense contractors ignore. Everybody's fighting over the same pie, but they're ignoring the crumbs. And when you're dealing with the Pentagon, crumbs are worth millions.
However, the government buys a whole bunch of stuff. I've seen them buy random cleaning supplies for national parks. I've seen them buy painter services to restore airplanes and museums. And I've seen, during COVID, I saw a ton of different contracts for buying ventilators and sanitary equipment and things like that. You might be thinking, this sounds kind of like a sales job, and it kind of is, except I think one of the big differences is that for a sales position, at least what I know of sales positions, is that your base salary is pretty meager, but your potential for bonuses is huge. The capture manager, on the other hand, has a very healthy base salary, and the potential for bonuses is huge, and I'll explain why in just a minute. However, the downside of this job is that it is very high stress and very high pressure. So you essentially don't get to control when the government releases a contract. They might drop it, they might tell you it's in February, but then they'll delay it out to March and then maybe even April. And because of that, you don't control your schedule. Let's say, and this has happened to me multiple times, that you have a vacation planned. Well, the government decides to drop the contract right at the start of your vacation. Well, you've been planning for this for months. This is a multi-million dollar contract and the timeline is short. So that means your vacation is now out the window, which people don't really love. In addition to that, and similarly related to that, is they're often high pressure situations, because they might give you like 5 business days, 7 business days to put an entire proposal with a price together. And so you are often working 10, 12, 15, 20 hour consecutive days in order to get it done. Because if you're even 1 second late, the government can be like, sorry, you're too late, you're disqualified. And that whole process has just gone out the window. And so this is why I believe that the base salary can be pretty healthy, unlike a traditional sales job. So what do I sell to the government? Well, health IT. It's the total opposite of war. So if the government says, hey, we need a system that is able to process healthcare claims better, that's what we do. We bid on these contracts and we provide people to build them a system that's able to do that. Now, I don't have an IT background. I know what I joked about earlier. I'm not an engineer. There are guys much smarter than me that are able to develop those solutions called solution architects, but I'm the guy that kind of works on the strategic end of it to, again, try to get the bid and proposal and the team as best as I can. And what's interesting before we finish this video is that capture managers don't just exist in the government space. They exist everywhere. Companies like Chipotle or even Shake Shack or anything, basically, they need to buy beef, right? And how do they find out where the cheapest and best beef they can find? They use contracts. And so the farms will have these capture managers that will basically put in proposals and bids to these large companies to be the beef dealer for these companies. So yeah, capture managers are everywhere. They exist in commercial space, they exist in the federal and government space. It's really cool. If you guys are interested, let me know. I answer any questions you guys have. Until next time, guys, stay safe, and as always, stay honest.